Have you ever been frustrated trying to close people, whether as a customer or distributor, into your network marketing business? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you my top three tips coming up. My name is Darren Kidd, and I've been in network marketing for over 25 years. I'm a multiple seven-figure earner in the industry. However, it wasn't always like that. Matter of fact, I failed for about 7 years. I joke and tell people I was a part of the NFL, however, it's not a joke, no friends left club after failing for 7 years. And it wasn't until I had the right mentors that came into my life that really changed everything. So on this channel, we give you weekly training content to help you succeed now in your network marketing business. Tip number one, amateurs convince, professionals sort. We're not looking for everyone. If they don't want to do the business, if they don't want to become a customer, you don't want them to, because no one's going to be happy. So as we're out there sorting through the people, I remember the late Jim Rohn saying, look, you're looking for the lookers. Our job is to take them from not knowing to knowing. And then as we guide them through the follow-up process, okay, then we take and we look for the people that see what we see. Okay, we go with the people that are going our way. So make sure you're not convincing. When I first got into network marketing, to be honest with you, yes, I would chase you from state to state. I was desperate, or country to country, and beg you to get in my business. Now I decide who I want to let in my business, because really we don't want to work with everyone. So you're almost interviewing them. Not only do they want to join the company and work with you, but do you want to actually work with them? Because if they're not ready, you really don't want them to get started, because no one's going to be happy in the end. Tip number two, remember, it's a process. It takes an average of 5 to 8 exposures for people to accept any information, good or bad. So our job is to take them from exposure to exposure as fast as we can, until really they recruit or sell themselves when the timing is right. So once again, if the timing's not right, we don't want them to do that. And some people, the timing's never gonna be right. But me personally, I never take anyone off of my list unless they make me mad and I don't wanna work with them. But no doesn't mean no, it means not now. So as you're understanding, look, you know, maybe they just got a pay raise. Maybe they love their job. Maybe life couldn't be any better. Then you just say, look, do you mind if I keep you posted on how I'm doing? Sure. Really, hardly no one ever says no. I don't know of anyone that's told me no. I don't want you to keep me posted and updated on how you're doing. And then maybe 6 months later, they got a new boss they can't stand. They got laid off, or the company got sold, or they want to put their kids in a private school. You know, something changes. And so no doesn't mean no. It means not now. Knowing that it is a process, and it's gonna take multiple exposures. I've had people that I've followed up with for years and just kept the relationship going, that ended up coming into my business, that became one of the top leaders in my business. And was it worth it? Yes, it was definitely worth it, because we generate a lot of income on a monthly basis from that one person. But most people, they don't stick to the process. What they'll do is they'll go out, they'll plant some seeds, they'll cultivate the ground, they'll even water the seeds once or twice, and then they go, hey, it doesn't work, and they quit. Where you can build your business and succeed and reap a big harvest just off of other seeds that people have planted that weren't able to stay strong enough, long enough during that process. Tip number three, ask the right questions. I learned this from Eric Worre, the founder of networkmarketingpro.com, a long time ago, okay? And so what he did was he gave us 6 questions, the right questions to ask. And if you go ahead and memorize these, they're very simple, but yet it helps people make a decision. Number one, what did you like best? Not what do you think. That's like saying, what do you think about the president? What do you think about politics? You're opening up a can of things that you don't want to open up. But when you say, what did you like best? You know, what caught your attention the most? Product, business, or both? No matter what, you win. That's question number one. Number two, on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being most excited, ready to get started, 1 not really excited at all, where do you see yourself? And don't hesitate to pause, just like I did. Okay, let them answer the questions. Basically, you're acting like a consultant when you're asking them these questions. Number three, how much money would you need to make on a part-time basis? Because most people, they are and they should be part-time as they're building their network marketing business. How much money would you need to make on a part-time basis to make it worth your while? Let's say they go, Darren, I need to make $1,000 a month. That brings us to question number four. How many hours a week are you able to work to get to that $1,000 an hour? So right now you're basically acting like a consultant. So you're going, now if they give you some crazy off the wall number, like, hey, I want to make $10,000 a month and I can only work 2 hours a week. That's not reasonable. I mean, you can even ask them, hey, look, I don't think that's reasonable. Like, what are you making right now at your job? And I'll guarantee you it's not that kind of income. So you have to adjust one of those numbers. Either you need to work a lot more hours or you need to bring that income down to something that's actually reasonable. So how many hours a week are you able to work? Then the next question, question number five, is how long would you be willing to give me to help you get to $1,000 a month working, let's say they gave us 10 hours a week. So again, you're acting like a consultant. You're filling in their numbers. And they go, well, I would be willing to give you 6 months. Let's say that's the number they gave you. And the last question, number six, is you're wrapping it all together, okay? If I would you, one of the most powerful questions you could possibly ask in network marketing. If I could show you how to get to $1,000 a month, working 10 hours a week over the next 6 months, is there anything else you need to know? Are you ready to get started? And that's when you zip it. You zip your lip, you don't say anything else. Even though it's very uncomfortable, sometimes it feels like it's, you know, minutes before someone says something, even though it's only seconds, either they're going to say, well, yes, I'm ready to get started, or they're going to give you the objection, the question that you need to answer, and then you can go, are you ready to get started? And then you can do a three-way call with your, you know, your sponsor, one of your mentors, one of your business partners, and get those questions answered. So those are my top closing tips. And remember, you're going to be bad before you're good. Every great network marketer was a lousy network marketer for a period of time. But just have fun, enjoy the process, lighten up, and your sales will brighten up. You know, if you're having fun and you're just honest with people and you're real and you're not trying to pretend to be something that you're not, they're going to appreciate that. So those are my top three closing tips. Question of the day. What is the number one objection that you get when you're sharing your opportunity with other people? Maybe it's no time, no money, let me think about it. I would love for you to put that in the comments below so I can go through and I can look at, you know, the most common objections and I can answer that on my next training video. Thanks for stopping by and watching this video. To make sure you don't miss any future videos, subscribe to the channel. Also, we put together a free resource for you. It's a free ebook. 3 keys on succeeding in your network marketing business. We're going to make sure we put the link on the video itself and in the description below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.